Guess who's Bazak? Live with the Humble Prince and Sahara FM Radio. Thank you, everybody, for tuning in. We really, really appreciate it. Again, tonight's show is brought to you by the law offices of Bonali Mayowa PC. Please go to their website, www.mayowalaw.com. Also, Lavina Skincare, www.lavina.com. And also, if you'd like to advertise on with the Sahara Media Group, please send an email to publisher@saharareporters.com, or you can send me an email to humbleprincelive@gmail.com. And right now, I'm joined by a very, very special guest, highly esteemed guest. And I was just telling all the fellas out there, all you Nigerian men out there, this is the second week in a row I've had a female professor on the show. You guys need to step your game up. All you guys do is just watch Arsenal, and Arsenal lost today, whatever, and write rubbish on Facebook. You need to hit the books so we can get some more male professors. But please, right now, let's welcome the beautiful Yetunde Odugbesan-Omede.
Thank you so much for having me.
Oh, I appreciate you coming on the show. So wait, did I pronounce the last name correctly?
Yes, Odugbesan-Omede.
Omede, yeah, got to put that. And you guys, she's a mother and she's married, so please stop sending me inbox. Can you show them that flash? Yeah, that flashlight. Whoa, making a lot of women jealous there. But thank you. Thank you so much for joining us, man.
Sure, really, really thank you so much for having me.
Yeah, fantastic. I just, you know, just wanted to have a, you know, casual conversation. I know you're doing a lot of things. For instance, I like to start here. I know you're the CEO of Yetunde Global Consulting. What is that about?
Yetunde Global Consulting is a management consulting firm where I specialize in leadership development and training in organizational management. So I work with nonprofits, companies, corporations, and making sure that their executive team is performing how they should perform and taking their team to the next level of performance.
And how long have you been doing this?
Since 2011.
Wow, and you've been doing this a while, and this is definitely taking you places, man. You've met some really prominent people, like my buddy, former President Bill Clinton.
Yes, Bill Clinton, yeah, Winnie Mandela, and the list goes on, yes.
Oh, wow, fantastic, man. Mm-hmm. So I know also you're the founder of the Young Women's Guide.
Yes.
Why don't you tell us what the organization
is
about?
So Young Women's Guide is a nonprofit organization that helps develop young women into leaders from all backgrounds, all over the world.
Okay.
I've done a lot of leadership seminars and conferences in South Africa, Canada, Nigeria, and I just want to make sure that when young women have the opportunity to lean in, that they are ready to do so. So there's a process to leadership, and we're making sure that they're groomed to be leaders.
You're a leader already, and you didn't even want to find out how old this lady is. And she is young, believing and doing big things. So which, of course, brings us, I know you wrote a book. Is this your first book?
Well, I've written a smaller book, which is a book of quotes, which was with my mentor, and he was the chair of my dissertation committee, Dr. Mark Holzer.
Okay.
So we wrote a book on public service.
Okay.
But this is my first book by myself, talking about specifically really for young women and how they can be leaders.
And of course, and as the self-titled book is called, The Young Women's Guide.
Yes,
so
it is.
What inspired you to write this book?
I just wanted to write a self-help manual, a guide that any young woman can pick up. Like if I was 16, 18, whatever age actually, they can pick up and say, okay, how can I learn more about self-esteem? How do I build my confidence? What are the steps that I need to take to be successful, whether it's in my personal life, in my professional life? What are the next steps that I need to take me to the next level? And I travel around the world speaking at various conferences and various universities to men and women. But at the same time, I really have a passion to make sure that young women excel and they exceed and they do exceedingly well. And I want this book to be something that they can just flip through whatever age they are and learn about themselves and how to lead, and also to make sure that they are holistically feeling fine. You know, that's really important, that we make sure that young women are well-rounded.
Fantastic.
So it's not all about the career, but it's about how are you feeling inside, right?
True.
Yeah.
Yeah. That's very interesting, man, because let's be honest, man, women do face a lot of challenges
they
and
do.
Everything, right?
They
so
do.
I think that would help, you know, groom them into becoming the woman that they really need to be, especially in this day and age.
Yes.
All of a sudden, I want to be a woman.
Maybe in my
next lifetime. But that's fantastic, man. Yeah. I'll be honest, you know, I got to, the book is out.
Yes, it
already is
out. You can go to Amazon.com.
Right.
It's in selected Barnes & Noble's websites. It's on my website, www.yetundeodugbesan.com.
Right.
So it's all over. So please do order the book. Give it to your friend, your best friend,
definitely,
your daughter,
man.
Your nieces, and so forth.
I'm actually getting one, and I'm going to give it out. We're going to do a contest. I ordered. I, I, no, I think I ordered or told him we're going to do a contest so we could give it out. Okay. Because the book, you know, like I said, I just perused through it. You know how you go on Amazon.
And I brought you a copy, too. It doesn't
matter. Oh, I didn't even know.
I have a copy.
Whoa, here. Please. Yeah. You got it. Well, that's mine because I want you to sign that.
That is yours, yes.
Yes, I'm definitely going to keep that. Thank you so much. Well, that's fantastic. So what do you think women can... And not, you know, the book, I know it says young women's guide, but I think men could benefit from the book too, right?
No, they can. I think you also, it has advice that it's not only just about gender or just about female, but when we talk about investing in yourself is one of the topics. I mean, that's something that a man can also sort of take some tips and tools on. Right. And one of the topics is also called Beware of Dream Killers.
Right.
Everyone has a dream. Everyone has a dream. So it's not only just a woman thing, it's a man thing. If you have a vision, if you have a dream, you have to protect it.
Right. So, you know, one thing I really wanted to say was, I wanted to ask you about those chapters, because there were other chapters that I saw that I really didn't delve into, but like there's one called Passion and Purpose.
Yes.
Tell us a little bit about that.
So passion and purpose to me is one of the whole things about why are we alive? Why are you here on this earth? What is your passion? And I believe that your passion is what leads you to really fulfilling your purpose. My passion at a young age was always to like inspire and motivate people. I would always get phone calls from my friends on, oh, can you give me advice about this? Right. Can you give me advice about that? I was always in some sort of a leadership position.
Right.
And I knew at a young age that I wanted to be able to lead people to become their better selves. And I had people do it for me. So it's when you find out what you are interested in, when it becomes a burning desire, that leads you to your fulfillment of your purpose. Because you can be successful, that still doesn't mean that you are fulfilling your purpose, your God-given purpose.
Oh, wow. That's fantastic. And, well, you know, that's good. So do you inject kind of like the belief of God and religion in this book or no?
No, I don't. I do reference him, yes, because for me, personally, I mean, he is an important factor in my life.
That's very bold of you
to
say that.
Who I am today, yes, of course.
Right. And it's a very secular society that we live in.
No, I believe in Jesus.
Amen. Hallelujah, Jesus.
So, yeah. But the thing is that I want, if you are a Muslim, if you are a Christian, if you are a non-believer, to be able to read this book and still be empowered and inspired. Right. It's not a book that separates anyone. It's a book that is inclusive.
That's fantastic. There's another chapter that I was really interested in called Having a Vision for Your Life. Why don't you talk about that a little bit?
Yeah, and I think there's a quote that goes like, a man without a vision perishes or something.
True.
Something with around that line.
Right.
But I would say that everyone should have a vision for their life.
Right.
Everyone should have some sort of vision that propels them to keep moving forward. At a young age, I've always had this grand vision for my life, and I still do. And that's what continues to push me. I mean, even as a little kid, you just see yourself, I want to be president or I want to be this.
Right.
Always hold on to that vision. It's so important because it means all the difference of who you'll become tomorrow.
Right. You say at a young age, you're still young. I'm not going to say your age
you
on the
can't have, hey,
but you're still
I'm
young.
An open
honestly,
book. You can,
you know, and I got to say, man, you know, it's one of our, and we're claiming you as one of our Nigerian women.
Yes,
of course. You're doing really big things. And, you know, we're going to take a break shortly because there's some other things I'd really like to ask you about, you know, and we're going to talk about the book as well. But, guys, if you have a question for Yetunde, please, we'd like to hear from you. The number to call is 646-559-6640. And again, extension 3. Nick, thank you. So the number to call is 646-559-6640, extension 3. Nick, please, let's try to put that on the screen as well. We'd like to hear from you. If you have any questions for Yetunde, just want to give her a shout-out, please. We'd like to hear from you. We're going to take a break, and when we come back, we'll continue to talk to Professor Yetunde Odugbesan-Omede. We'll be right back. Good stuff.
On February 14th, Valentine's Day, Nigerians will not be exchanging roses and boxes of chocolates. No! Instead, Nigerians will be going to the polls to let their presidents win. Over 10 candidates are on the ballot, but the real contenders are just two. Incumbent President Goodluck Jonathan and opposition leader, retired General Muhammadu Buhari. Young Nigerians on social media have defined this upcoming contest for themselves. The Buhari supporters called it #FakeBuhari, while the Jonathan supporters called it #JEJMyVow. The line of conflict between Jonathan and Buhari was drawn long ago when, as a graduate student, Jonathan was forced by Buhari's military regime to stay on long lines for milk and bread. Jonathan has not forgotten or forgiven. No, and Buhari is not apologizing. Mixing religion and politics has produced numerous fireworks. One famous pastor, Evido Edeko, threatened over the weekend to slam open the gate of hell for those who oppose the president. On social media, commentators felt he must be a permanent resident or a green card holder to have the keys to hell. Conventional wisdom is that the ideals of Nigeria have not been tried and found wanting. Instead, they have been found difficult and left untried. But on social media, Nigerians are daily trying those ideals, one video, one picture, one story at a time. Join as we count down.
Radio for all. You are now live with the Humble Prince on Sahara FM Radio. Yeah.
Yep, we're back. Live with the Humble Prince on Sahara FM Radio. Thank you, everybody, for tuning in. Again, tonight's show is brought to you by the law offices of Bolanle Mayowa PC. Please go to the website, www.mayowalaw.com. Also, www.lavina.com. That's for Lavina Skincare. And also, tonight's show is brought to you by the Women's Guide by Yetunde A. Odugbesan. Young Women's Guide. Yeah, for young women. So if you're over a certain age, this would be, I'm just joking. I was gonna say if you're over a certain age, this book is not for you. But this book is for everybody. Yetunde just gave me my copy. This is gonna be a keepsake and a masterpiece, because I'm gonna get it autographed before she leaves. Again, Yetunde, thank you so much for joining us. And again, and if you'd like to hear from you, if you have any questions for Yetunde, just wanna give her a shout out, please call. The number to call is 646-559-6640, extension 3. And of course, we're still joined by the lady herself. So I wanted to ask you, and you know, this is just not to even appease you or anything, but your mother,
yes.
your wife,
yeah.
Okay, and also, you're like a mover and a shaker. Like, how do you balance all that out? Because you, I mean, I follow you on your Instagram and Facebook. I mean, you've really done a lot of things, especially during the time during the when the girls were kidnapped.
Yeah.
You know, you were doing a little, yeah. So please go ahead.
I think, you know, balance is something that you have to forcefully like seek. For me, even though I'm a mother, even though I'm a wife, my mother always reminded me. She said, just because you're a wife and just because you're a mother doesn't mean you should sit back. That means you should even go out there and work harder.
Thank you. Yeah, women, so are you listening?
I don't think that you don't lose yourself becoming a mother. I think it's a part of who you are. Being a mother is one of my roles. Being a wife is one of my roles.
Fantastic.
But being a, you know, a professor, being a author are all part of me. And I nurture those areas because that's who I am. And like I always said, hold fast to your vision. As life changes, and it will change, hold fast to what you want to become.
Right.
Don't let the changes of life stop you from achieving your goals. If anything, embrace it.
Right, hold on, let's take have a caller. Sure. You're live with the Humble Prince, Sahara FM Radio. What's your name and where you calling from? Hello? Don't be shy.
Hello?
Yes, hi, you're on air. What's your name and where you calling from?
Hello?
Hello? We can hear you, can you hear us? Yes, we can hear you.
Yes, hi. I'm calling to be on the show, on the Live with the Humble Prince show.
Oh, you are live. We can hear you.
Oh, okay. Hi. Sorry, I couldn't hear you properly. Hey, Olu. Hi, Yetunde.
How are you?
Oh, hey, Delaco, thanks for calling. What's up?
Of course. Well, I didn't call to talk to you anyway, but I can see you're being on your best behavior today.
Yeah, well, you know,
I think it really does depend on who.
Yes, the caliber of guest it takes my behavior,
well
definitely.
Today.
Yeah. Maybe if you've met former President Clinton and Winnie Mandela and other big shots, then I'll behave myself.
Sorry, I can barely hear you.
Okay. Hello? Yeah. Can you hear us now?
A little bit better, but go ahead. Yeah.
No, I'm just saying, yes, the quality and caliber of my guest does dictate my behavior. Yep, you're right.
Hi, Yetunde.
Hi, how are you, Dalakwa?
Hi. Actually, no, we kind of go way back. But I am actually not calling because I necessarily have a question.
Sure.
I just think that your book is amazing. I've actually, from your posts, I've gone through some of the chapters.
Yeah.
I think it's such an amazing thing to write. I have a younger sister, and I feel like she definitely needs to read this book. And I feel like a lot of young females don't necessarily, I mean, they have this passion, but they don't necessarily know what
right.
to do to achieve it,
mm-hmm.
or they don't know what steps to take, and they don't have enough confidence in themselves to even feel like they can achieve
yeah.
these goals and these visions that they have. So I just want to say well done.
Thank you so
the book,
much.
And I hope that you left my copy as well in the video. Yeah.
Yes. Thank you so much. I really appreciate that.
I just want to
Thank
say
you.
Well done. I mean, and then what inspired you necessarily to write the book?
Yeah, thank you so much.
I know you've been doing this work for a while, but mm-hmm. I mean, did you just feel like it's time?
It was always
feel like a lot of the girls you met just needed to know,
yeah.
and just didn't necessarily have the right tool.
Yes, I felt it was time. But the thing about it is I always kept this journal and I kept
right.
a blog called Putting Your Best Self Forward that I started as a freshman in college.
Wow.
And I always tell people that don't despise small beginnings because it's that blog that helped me and inspired me to write this book.
Okay.
I would write advice columns and all of those things. And I took all of that and I put my heart into something that when a young woman reads it, she's more empowered. She feels she has the self-confidence, and she can wake up in the morning and say, okay, I can take the next necessary steps to really achieving some of the goals that I have for my life. So I just thought it was time. And I think with the world that we live in today, young women need to continue to be empowered and inspired.
That is fantastic, man. And I'm definitely really impressed. So I know you talked about how you balance being a mover and a shaker and all
mm-hmm.
that. So I know I made jest of it earlier, but you're also a professor of political science and
yeah.
global affairs.
Mm-hmm.
Do you enjoy teaching?
I do. I love teaching. I love instilling knowledge into my students.
Okay.
I love the topics that I do teach.
Right.
I did go to school for this, so this is an area that I am interested in.
Oh, okay.
And even much interesting is I also teach a course called Women in Comparative Political Development. So it's very interesting to see some of the obstacles and issues that women have gone through throughout the centuries.
Okay.
And it's still going through, but still looking at some of the beacon of lights who sort of paved the way when we talk about women's rights and voting
right.
rights and so forth.
Right. And it's a shame that, you know, in this day and age, women are still going through a lot of discrimination.
Yeah.
Especially, you know, I'm not going to say religion, but religion is used to discriminate against women a lot. You know,
yes.
Jimmy Carter wrote a book about that and
mm-hmm.
everything. So,
yeah.
You know, you and I were talking earlier and you said you were just in Nigeria like 5 months ago and everything. And you said you could actually live there, which is good. But I just wanted to get you, what do you think about the 2015 election being postponed and just the general climate of the election itself, and who do you think is going to win?
I don't know who's going to win.
Right.
We always kind of see that the incumbent, you know, president has a little bit of an advantage.
Yeah, the incumbent, right. The incumbent has never lost.
But given the landscape of things, given some of the issues and circumstances that have happened in Nigeria,
right.
It's going to be sort of a tough race.
I think that
both parties do have overwhelming support. The
right.
APC has their own support. PDP has their own
they
support.
They sure do, yeah.
And also, you know, there are a lot of things and happening in Nigeria that's
yeah.
making this a very contentious electoral race. So
right.
I don't know who's going to win, but
okay.
I wish both parties best of luck, and I hope that we will ensure that this is a free and fair election.
It's got to be. Yeah, because this is one of the most monumental, most important elections in the history of our
yeah.
country.
And
so.
The security and safety of all Nigerians should be the number one priority for both candidates.
Definitely, man, because that's the one grudge I have against the incumbent, man.
Right.
Boko Haram grew balls under his watch, and I'm sorry, they just terrorized. But, you know, of late, they seem to have been doing a good job, so we'll see how that plays out. But all that, thank you so much. But let's talk about your upcoming book event on March 6th, 2015. Yes. Yeah, so please
so
talk a little bit about
that. So my upcoming
book
event is March 6th, yes, on Friday at 5 p.m.
Right.
It will be at the Consul General of Nigeria, the Nigerian Embassy in New York.
Right.
You do have to register because of security and so
definitely
forth in order to enter into the building. But it will be my book reading, author Q&A, book signing. You can buy the book there. It's sort of a mini sort of reception and celebration about the debut of this book.
Yeah, and it's free, so...
Yes, it is free.
Come in. And please come out and support one of our own. And, you know, she's doing wonderful things. And she's so humble. Very humble. Very, you know, a lot of women that don't even haven't accomplished or achieved half of what you have achieved. You can't even talk to them. Who are you talking to, man? I'm just talking. Anything else we can expect from you coming up in the future?
I'm just working on a lot of projects. I have a lot of conferences coming up geared towards young women.
On
March 28th, we have one of our biggest conferences,
right,
which will be hosted by Rutgers University. Over 100 and plus young women.
Oh,
great,
okay,
panelists. Traveling sort of all over the place with the book readings. And I do have on social media all of my book tour dates. So you can always go to my website, www.yetundeodugbesan.com, to just find out some updates and where I am next.
Yes, thank you, guys. We could also put that on the screen, too. It's www.yetundeodugbesan.com. And
yes,
she's also on Facebook, and you can follow her on
Instagram,
Twitter.
And Instagram. I am Yetunde at Instagram.
Right. Yeah, fantastic. So, Yetunde, thank you so much for coming on Live with the Humber.
Thank
this
you for
definitely
having
a,
me.
Definitely
thank
a pleasure.
Thank you for having me.
Really. Yeah, Nick, fantastic with the applause, man. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
On that note, we're going to take a break. And when we come back, we'll get more of Live with the Humble Prince on Sahara FM Radio. Thank you very much. All right, so thank you so much.